tonight, Phil, after a huge round one. We can't wait.
Exactly. The panel, Jim. We've got a huge, huge panel.
No, we have. We're going to get to the panel in just a sec. Before we do that, I want to tell you what's happening on this massive show. And it starts with this superstar from the St Kilda Footy Club, the captain ahead of his 300th game, Nick Riewoldt, on the show tonight.
Also,
the best in footy show, the AFL's best dog, will be crowned tonight. We can't wait for that. Stevie J, the Chompers, is on the show. We can't wait to speak to him. And, of course, the race that stops the football nation.
Yes.
That's coming up as well, Bill, the Footy Show Stakes. So it is a massive show tonight.
It is indeed. But the panel, Jim, let me tell you, probably one of the best-looking panel, I would have thought.
It won't be because you're on it, Fat, so go and take your seat. Bill Bayless, everybody, he's on the panel. Down the end there, and joining him from the Melbourne Footy Club, Bernie Vince is on the Footy Show.
Come on, Joel.
When you introduce someone, Bill, give it a bit of oomph.
Well, the crowd were bloody too loud. Joel, did you hear me?
Mate, I didn't hear you.
Oh, the captain of the Geelong Cats, Joel Selwood!
We can't wait to speak to you, boys. Very, very nice touch too, all of them. Bernie's off to a win, so they're in a happy mood, and so they should be. And so is this man. Mr. Football, there's no one been more important to this game for the last 40 years,
Mr.
actually.
Football.
300 games for the Cats, and he is in very, very good form. Make him welcome. John, Sammy Newman.
Yeah.
Doing dressed like that, please.
Have I missed something? Has it not lasted the distance?
What are you talking about?
Mate, I've been counselled 3 times this week.
Yes.
I was flown to Sydney for an etiquette and decorum forum.
Yes.
Where is...
You're talking about the beautiful Rebecca Madden, who is, of course, a great new addition, ladies and gentlemen, to the Footy Show. Sam, she's been here a day and a half, so we thought we'd probably get her feet under the desk and nice and comfortable, and she'll be out here next week.
Well, I have to rent the suit again.
No. What have you got there, by the way?
I've got some flowers. Well, let's see who we can give them. Ivy. Now, Ivy.
Oh.
I know another person got into trouble for saying this. Would you come out with me? I love you. Uh-huh. Right, well, here, you can have these flowers.
There we are.
We'll keep them out the back for you. We'll give them to you at the end of the show. Ivy's 95, or next in September, when the Saints get into the finals. 95 was one of our first people we spoke to on Street Talk.
Yep, and she has been a star ever since. Right, it's great to see you. Ivy, thanks very much for coming on. Sit down, Sam.
All right.
Because we've got lots to get through.
Jimbo. Now, down at Geelong, we've had a great new recruit over the off-season. We've had a few, actually.
Yes.
May I say, the Footy Show have outdone themselves by getting Beck. We've had a bit to do with her down at Geelong, and we wish her all the best on the Footy Show.
Yeah, she is a star.
She is outstanding.
Number one.
She'll be on next week, so make sure you're watching that, of course, as if you wouldn't be. Now, speaking of debuts, 30 years ago, Sel, have a look at some of this vision. You won't believe this. This is a man who was playing for the Cats for the first time. Watch what happens here. Bill Brownell's in the goal. Oh!
Don't wait for it. No.
Bill. That's your debut game against Fitzroy 30 years ago. We went back. Bill.
I actually got the ball handballed to Jacko.
We went back through the archives and absolutely without any exaggeration,
no.
That was the only vision we could find.
No, that is not true because I kicked 2 goals, took 8 marks.
Well, the interesting bit from us, Bill, is that you sort of finished as you started. We're going to wander through this chronologically because that was Bill's first game. We then fast-tracked to the 89 grand final where... Just head over, then into the prelim. And this is, of course, the game on the line and Bill just falls over there. And then the Legends game, Bill.
Look at this goal.
Oh! Willis.
That's not me.
This could not be me. This was the start we were
on. Oh, fair dinkum.
That was the first minute
there
of the Legends game.
There must be a highlight there. What about the goal after the siren?
No, we've seen enough of that.
11 at the Gabba.
Still a
record.
I don't think we're ever going to see that. No. Joel Selwood, very nice to see you. Cracking start to the season.
It was. I mean, it was a good start by the boys. We, came out and did what we wanted to do. In the first half, we fell asleep for a little bit, but it was good that the boys, you know, matured as a group a little bit and got it done in the
you
end.
You missed massive slabs of the pre-season, so how did you pull up yourself?
Oh, I pulled up well. I was, I played a little bit of the second quarter, started on the bench in the third, which helped me run out the game and probably look to do similar over the next few weeks.
Oh, but Charlie, it was about one man. One man only. What about the danger? He was unbelievable, wasn't he?
He was good.
Oh,
he was okay.
43 touches.
We also had Big Zach that played a pretty big role.
No, we're talking about Paddy. What? How good was Paddy?
No, he did have a fair day. he had a fair day. I mean, he's very good to play with. Been watching him for a long time.
Oh. Was that you, Bill?
Wardrobe malfunction.
How did that creep in?
What was that?
I've got no idea.
Oh, no.
But you will. Sel, it's fair to say that Bill
Danger had a very good day and night. Gee whiz.
Bill's been your number one fan ever since you started playing for the Cats, but you wouldn't have slipped you by that last week he, of course, was on the throne.
Well,
here's the new King of Geelong.
Branded him the new King of Geelong.
Yes.
Out came the throne.
It's what you love about him.
New King of Geelong. How did that sit with you, Sel, as he jumped off?
Well, no, I thought I would have been, you know, in the running for it now that Stevens moved on to GWS, and I thought I might have been in the running, but it didn't take long, did it?
No, Jolly. I love you. I've always loved you. But I tell you what, I love the danger more. Oh! And let's have a look at this. I'll show you something here. Look, you ready? Look. And we got number 14. But look at that. We got number... star, and we love him. He's going to win the Brownlow, he's going to win the Norm Smith. Come on, Joel, you do something, I'm off you.
Well, I don't know where we've got that jumper from. We haven't been sponsored by Feeler for a long time. So, anyway, he played very well, though, I'll give him that. You can keep 35 on there for the moment. I'll try and get a kick this week.
Doesn't drink beer, Bill.
That's a very good point, actually, Bernie. Yes, and he doesn't, does he? He's a bit different like that.
Well, you know.
Not that that's a bad thing.
Hey, Posh, when was the last time you saw a Geelong jumper filled out like that?
Looked like sort of a giant methane tank. Joel. you would have been, the side would have been a little edgy that you actually had Hawthorn's measure because they've had it over you in recent times and it might have been a nerve-wracking experience to start with. And mind you, they might have taken it a bit easy. They didn't seem to mind Dangerfield at all. They just let him run.
Oh, yeah, Sam Mitchell was doing a fair job for them in doing what he does too. They were, you know, crossing paths a fair bit over the day. But, yeah, obviously we had a plan going in that, you know, it was either Danger or Mark Blitzarves that we wanted to look after Sam. And end up playing the way that it did. The first half obviously went to plan. Sam probably turned the tables a little bit in that third quarter and they got a bit of a run on, so a good start.
All right, we've got Stevie J not far away and we're looking forward to you crossing swords with him, Joel.
Yes.
Of course, your former premiership teammate, but what about
swords.
The Demons?
Swords!
Of course, undefeated in the pre-season and now won their first round clash against Stevie's mob, of course, GWS. So, Bernie, you must be very happy down there.
Yeah, very happy. Very happy the way the boys are playing. Obviously, we were probably a club that really needed to win in the NAB Challenge just to get that winning feeling. The wins are a bit far between at
few
the D's.
Far between.
Yeah, I've got a bit stuck.
Bernie.
But it's important for us to win and get used to winning. So we come from behind in every game we played in the NAB Challenge. And again, on the weekend, we were nearly four goals down at three-quarter time. So we're very happy to get over the line.
Clayton Oliver, who won the NAB Rising Star, said after the game that you gave an inspiring speech at three-quarter time. What did you say to get the demons over the line?
Oh, I actually can't remember. You asked me that before. Must have been very inspiring. But
did you talk to him?
I did talk to him, but I get caught up in it. I don't know what I said. Did he like it?
No, he said it was inspiring, and that's why you won.
Why okay. were you? What was Paul Ruse just not with us at the time?
He's still with us, I think.
What did he say? Why did he let you speak?
I just said to keep the belief. We've been through a lot of testing times over the pre-season, and just to believe.
Training camp belief. At Rochdale?
Training camp, that was tough.
You mentioned that?
Yeah.
Belief.
Hey, what we have noticed with you, right. Bern, is that you've branched out a little, as well as being an unbelievably good footballer. You've moved into the business world, and we saw this. This is Clint Stanaway, of course, from the high rating, in fact, number one rating, Nine News. But here's Bern doing some real estate work. Tell us what this is about, please.
Look at the business cards. Look, you watch this, where he puts it. Wait for it. Oh, sitting there. Oh, Bernie.
Very important to have the business cards in the right spot. So ventured out with a mate of mine and been getting a little bit of experience over the last couple of years and ended up joining up with him and venturing out with Pride Real Estate Paran. So,
good Pride.
So you're a realtor?
I am, yeah.
And with a view to...
Yeah, after footy, it's certainly something that I enjoy. So,
do you?
Yeah, something I'll look forward to. What do you enjoy, Sam?
Hey?
What do you enjoy?
Not a lot these days, Bernie.
Well, Sam only owns about 15 houses, furnish him with one.
Speaking of ads, Joel, you're going to love this.
Okay.
This court hour, have a look at this. Joel and Scotty.
We're looking to go on an end-of-season brocation. Can you help us?
Sure thing. Step this way. When it comes to travel options, Canada.
Hey,
Germany.
With a dog.
That's very good.
After long travel, we go the extra mile.
I didn't think that one was going to get past the footy show, well done, guys.
Well, you've got first-class travel around the world 10 times from Stuart there at Geelong Travel.
Well, no, Stuart, he's a good friend down at Geelong Travel. He tells us that he's the best in Australia, and he does do a good job, but, he did stitch us up.
We have had some appalling ads over the journey, none more appalling than these two. Let's start with Bill, who did a membership campaign back in 2011 for the Cats. What are you doing here?
For nothing. I was a professor coming up with the right concoction. Jim?
And?
To loyalty, spirit, and ticker. DNA. Yeah, that'll do. Well, you just do
a great cement salesman himself from 1977.
That's why I chose these handy Melcan and King concrete and mortar in bag. Melcan and King, convenience in a bag.
Yeah. There you are, Sam. You've been working so hard.
You look like half of Hall & Oates.
It's terrible, isn't it?
And that's your very, very lovely assistant, Jacinta Clayton.
That's my, for want of a better word, PA. Scott Clayton's charming wife.
You're magnificent.
And, we've been together for 20 years.
Yeah, Bernie, we've had you on a few times on here, and we found a quote from you from the record when you're playing for the Crows. And they asked you, what would you love to do? I'd love to get on the footy show and sing Sweet Home Alabama. Now, Bernie, this is your lucky night, my friend, because us here at the footy show, we make dreams come true. Come on, Bernie. To get up later.
No, Raffy.
Do you want to see Bernie sing?
Yeah! We'll see.
All they're lacking is a lead singer. Yes. Look at that setup. There's a microphone out the front.
Bill might do it for me.
No, you're up. You are up.
Okay, righto.
You going to do it?
Nah, I don't think so. I've grown up.
By the end of tonight, are you going to be the lead singer in front of that band singing The Great Sweet Home Alabama?
I wouldn't have thought so.
Trust all of us, that is coming up, so don't leave right until the very end. But let's get stuck into footy. What about Friday night? How big's this game? The Tigers and the Maggies.
It was interesting to hear Treloar's comments throughout the pre-season, thinking that Collingwood's list was more of in a premiership race than what Tigers were at the time, but still... Justin Martin obviously had a big week last week, and with Greg and Hunt coming back in, it'll be an interesting lineup.
And Jaden Short too. Looks like he's playing his first game. That's fantastic.
Can't get Bertolino right, Bill.
No, he might miss another couple too. And Big Ivan's not playing also. But I've got a fat stat. Hashtag fat stat for you, Jim. Yes. You'll love this. All winners from round one are playing the losers from round one.
Nice.
That is a good fat stat. They got no idea. But hey, that is a good fat stat. Right.
Who's going to win the game, please?
I'm going with Collingwood to bounce back.
I think that will happen too. I think Collingwood will win.
Yeah, Collingwood for me as well. I reckon they'll bounce back this week. They're pretty poor last week, so.
Well, that is amazing, Jim. I reckon right in round two, Collingwood's season is on the line.
Really?
Right now. And if they're going to hang in there, they must win this game, and I think they will beat Richmond.
Enormous at the MCG Friday night. Speaking of enormous, this show has got plenty in it, so do not go away.
Yeah! Tonight on the Footy Show, the players' boosters are put through their final paces. Find out who takes home the boatload. New member of the 300 Club, Big Nick Revolt, joins us live. Oh, when the Saints go marching in, find out just how much dirt we can dig up from the bottom of the mailbag.
Make it sexy. Sexy.
Don't we always, Gil? We'll cross live to that giant of a man, Stevie J, to discuss his first big clash against the Cats. Woohoo, Stevie! The Prince of Purple, Damien Barrett, will be in with all the biggest news in football. And right after this, saddle up for the biggest horse race in town, the mighty Footy Show Stakes. That's tonight on the Footy Show.
The Footy Show Stakes.
All set now for the running of the 11th annual Mark Robinson Credibility Cup. Or is it the 10th? Could be the 9th. Actually, might only be the 6th or 7th. Bugger it. Let's just go with it. Racing. Usually a slow starter, the North Melbourne horse first out with no jockey, folks. My mistake. There's Boomer. Next is Travis Cloak on. Might actually need two gloves. And Jack Watts on about f***ing time. His old mare Basket Case now finally put out to pasture. Settling in now, here comes Collingwood on illicit drugs. Flat boy Eddie McGuire on. There's other clubs, you know. And Nathan Buckley on. See, it's not just a game plan. Moving up alongside is Russ Lyon on. Don't mention the game plan. And swooping in to save both from a wave of criticism, it's Hugh Jackman on Bondi Rescue. You wouldn't read about it. Basket Case has found a rider. Gil McLaughlin, buddies all over the shop. And what's this? It looks like Collingwood have stopped off to purchase up to 11 Souvlakis. Into the final straight now. It's Jack Watts making his case, sir. It's Boomer. It's Hugh. It's the Collingwood bus finding something down the outside. You heard it here. Their season's back on track.
Footy Show Stakes. We might hear from Ed before the end of the night.
No. Ed would be circumspect about it.
Would he?
Would go. I think he would.
Yes. Well, yeah. I tell you what we need to do, and that's get stuck into some very serious football, because there are some big matches this round, but none are bigger than this. The Grand Final replay. MCG Birmingham.
Miss Hodge with that broken arm. A couple of young fellas could debut. And then moving on to West Coast. Doing pretty quick, I like to be quick. Leroy Jenner coming in for possibly his first game for the West Coast Eagles. So obviously add some pace to that already pacey midfield. And it's obviously a big game. And who do you think will win, Bill?
Well, Josh Kennedy on fire last week with 8 goals, and Chip Frawley was okay on Easter Monday game, so that'll be a great matchup. But another interesting stat that the West Coast Eagles have only won four of their last 18 games at the MCG, so that tells me the Hawks are going to win this one.
Yeah, the grand final rematch would be interesting. Oh, I think the Eagles, you know, they were running well last week and they'll want to get one back on the Hawks, I think.
But I haven't heard a winner for
set. I've seen Hawthorn will bounce back from last week in another big game for them. I think they'll win.
Always said that you are ahead of the game. I've always said that you're ahead of the game in so many ways.
Yeah.
And you may remember we had Luke Hodge on last week, and prophetically, Sam asked him this question.
Did he say, won't be here?
He had a number of things saying, what he said was, he said it doesn't matter about your burst, he said a whole range of things. But he said, don't forget, you're only one injury away.
So, he's now had that one injury, and he's going to miss 4-6, Hodgie.
Yeah, but probably it was just an attempt by Alistair Clarkson just to rev him up. He doesn't need revving up. He'll be back, won't he?
Oh, no question.
Jim, can I ask you a question? Yes. Say Rebecca was here at the minute.
Yes.
What input would she have had? So would you have hogged the whole thing?
No.
Would she introduce anything?
Yes, or
would she
be sharing duties and
interview with Stephen Johnson? Or yep. What would she be doing?
Well, we haven't had that.
You can't just... Take over.
Given that we haven't had the interview with Stevie yet, she wouldn't have had a chance to lead that, but she would happily lead that.
And how would you go with her, Foss?
Hey?
How would you go with Beck sitting there?
How would I go?
Yeah.
Well, I'd be sitting here next to her.
On your best behaviour?
Of course. Have we had some instructions about that?
Have you got a winner for us in this?
I'm tipping the Hawthorn side, only because of being...
Interesting, as I said, football matches all around this round two, and this one will garner great interest because of the fact that a legend of the Geelong Footy Club switched over to GWS and for the first time plays against his old team. He's been good enough to jump on a link from Sydney, and it's time to welcome Stevie J, everybody, to the Footy Show. Welcome, Stevie.
G'day, boys.
All right, a couple of questions for me before the boys all jump in. Your first outing against your old club, that must feel strange in the build-up and will feel strange when the game starts.
Yeah, for sure. There's definitely a range of emotions that I'll be going through going into the game. Obviously, I had a wonderful time at Geelong, spending 14 years playing there, and to come up against my old teammates will be a weird feeling, but I guess I've just got to focus my emotions into playing my role for the GWS, and hopefully we can have our first win for the season.
You copped a nice pasting on the back of round one, people suggesting that you weren't handballing when you should have been and all the rest of it. Is there anything justified in it, Stevie, or is it a bit overblown?
I think you open yourself up for criticism, especially when you kick 8 goals, 16, and you lose the game by 2 points. There are certainly times where we could have been more composed with the footy. Sometimes you take the responsibility on yourself to kick the goal when things aren't going your way, but hopefully... We've addressed that internally, and hopefully we can improve on that this week. And some of the guys that have been, condescending in their appraisal of us can sort of get behind us in the coming weeks.
Condescending, that's a good word, Stephen. You've learned up there in Sydney. Three premierships, a Norm Smith medal, and still love down there at the Cattery. Don't worry about that. This is the official Geelong Cats calendar for 2016 this year. There's Joel, Tomahawk, Amotz, and you're in it. How did you get yourself in it?
Am I?
Yeah, you're in it. Of course you
know. Well, maybe the marketing department were more confident in my ability to play on, but I guess it all comes down to them wanting to sell copies, Bill.
Well, the other photo that'll be of great interest to you, Sel, is this one here of Bill, of course, the King of Geelong, or formerly, before Danger took over. What's going on here?
That's at the Valley Inn, one of Stephen's favourite haunts down there at Geelong.
What's the jumper you're wearing?
Oh, we'd had 36 pots and...
Each.
That was before race 5, Bill.
Very good, Dogs. You've got a beautiful piece of artwork in the background too. Do you want to talk us through that one?
Aaron picked that up recently. Obviously, moving to a new house, she wants to get everything new, but it's not too bad, is it?
They must be paying you well, mate. But I got a message from...
The credit card's taking a hit.
Absolutely. They must be paying you well. Mate, I got a message from
you. No, not at all, Joel. Peanut.
Got a message from you in the ad break wanting me to ask you, who are you going to belt this weekend?
Who am I going to belt?
Yeah.
Geez, I might have to start with you.
I thought that one would be coming.
Wow. I used to get a bit annoyed with your nose before a game. I could never hear the coach's address, his instructions before the game because of your heavy breathing. So maybe that's why I'm up here now, because I never followed them.
Well, hopefully there's enough oxygen up there for the both of us.
Now, Stephen, it is a reason. I know there's a degree of humour in that, but it is a reasonable question. You've been prone to be undisciplined. What happens if the Cats try and suck you in to do exactly what Joel's speaking about? You've got to be very careful because you'll be a disservice to the side, won't you?
That's exactly right, Sam. No, I've got to go out there and, as I said, put the emotion and everything that I might be feeling into trying to play a role for the team. And, you know, all those side antics don't really get you too far anyway, so... you know, if anyone's going to come up and have a crack at me, I probably hope it's Andrew Mackie, because I'll be able to snap him in half.
Hey, Stevie, we can get serious just for a sec. A very disappointing round one for your footy club. I reckon you would have internally thought we got Melbourne. Very good chance to get the season off to a good start. You're 20-odd points up early in that final term and then we're run over.
Yeah, we're under no illusions that they're going well. I think they had a really good NAB Cup campaign where they were, you know, trying to get some wins on the board and some confidence going forward. As I said before, we didn't make the most of our opportunities early in that game of footy, and it came back to bite us late in the game where they were really good in the finish and were able to get over the top. So we really need to improve this week if we're to be any chance of beating Geelong, especially the way they played on Monday against Hawthorn.
Stevie, Bernie here, mate. One thing I love about you is you're a big game player. How many goals can we expect this weekend?
Bernie, after the criticism I've copped this week, I'll be running around trying to handball to my teammates all day. So maybe just two or three.
And bring the nail files too, mate. I've heard they're a bit long this last week.
The what, sorry? He's missed.
Bring the nail files, I think he said, Stevie. Yeah. So,
right. Sorry, Joel's. Joel's been victim of those the nails a few times at
Absolutely.
Training. So,
hey, Willis, let's have a look at this game. Mates, very important for GWS.
It's a huge game. You're right. The Giants, who lost last week, they led by 21 points at three-quarter time, and some very good ins here. Hoskin Elliott, very good player. The general pattern is back. Caniglio is back, and Willow is also back in. Some good ins there. That's a squad. Stewart goes out. Stevie J named there. The Mighty Catters! And into the squad there comes Cowan, Daniel Menzel, who played in the VFL last week, and George Hall and Smith come into that side. Whoever gets dropped will be very unlucky because they were fantastic last Monday. Good game, this one, in Canberra. How'd he go in Canberra?
We had a good game there last year. We played GWS in the middle of the year. They had a few injuries. A tough side to beat.
Yes, indeed. So I think the Cats might win. Not bad odds there. $1.45. Joel, you obviously think the Cats are going to win. Bernie?
Well, yeah, we do. But 48,000 members so far, Bill, on our way to 50,000. So 1,300. Go Cats,
yeah.
And hopefully get up to that 50,000 in no time.
Bernard?
Yeah, I think the Cats as well, mate. GWS play that real slingshot type footy, and they need you to turn it over in your forward line, and they really slingshot it back quickly. So if Geelong can stop it at the source, I think they'll get over the line.
Samuel?
A danger game for the Cats. But having said that, Jim, remember I said this. They'll play in the grand final, Geelong, no doubt of that this year. They mightn't win it, but they'll play in it. And Stephen, if you're still listening, take no notice of the critics, those people who sit in their lounge room. If you get the ball and you think you can kick a goal, have a shot, mate. Don't worry about hand passing it, kick a goal.
Thanks, Sammy.
Hey, Stevie. Word has come through that the wedding invitations are out. Of course, your beautiful partner Erin and yourself not far away. Well, end of the season. I also understand that you've received one, Fat?
Well, not really, Jim. I got to save the date.
All right.
What does that mean?
With a save the date, Stevie, our interest
is... It's pretty much an invite.
Our interest is around whether he's going to be in the bridal party, our big mate Fat here. Is any word on that?
Oh, he's in contention. He's right in the mix.
Who else you got?
A spot might open up after this weekend's game. Who knows?
Who else you got, Stevie? You got no
mates. Well, I haven't asked anyone yet, Bill. So just, you know, just keep giving me a phone call every now and then, checking up on me, and you know, you might just swiftly find yourself up there with me.
And get married in Sydney too. Yeah. Getting married in Sydney, I thought it might have been Wangaratta or Geelong. And he's been up there for 3 months and all of a sudden he loves Oxford
Don't
Street.
Don't worry, he's ensconced in Sydney, Stevie. Those chompers have got a little white dusting too. He's got a real mirror ball. Look at him in the champ. Hey, we absolutely love you, Stevie. You know that. You're a great favourite of the Footy Show. Thanks for giving us a couple of your minutes. Good luck. Massive game on the weekend.
No worries. Thanks a lot, boys.
And you, Stevie.
That man's a star. Norm Smith, three-time premiership player, says all you need to know. We are going to a break. Speaking of stars, not far away, the superstar from St Kilda, Nick Revolt. It came to our attention during the week that Bernie Vince back in 2006 stated that one of his lifetime ambitions was to sing Sweet Home Alabama on the Footy Show. That's before he'd even been on the show. Oh, so,
I can't remember everything.
Bill went and organised a band from somewhere.
I did.
And you got a microphone.
I got a microphone, Bern. Come on.
Well,
the crowd...
We guarantee it'll happen before the show finishes, don't worry. But speaking of Burn and his team, Bill, they are in excellent shape, the Demons. They've won their last four games. Of course, the one for big points on the weekend. They take on Joel Selwood. The Bombers on the weekend.
They come out Hartley and Fantasia. Out go Simkin, Bird and McKernan taking on Melbourne. And the ins are Lumumba and Brayshaw. And out go Frost and McDonald. The younger McDonald, that is. Tough game. Who do you reckon you're going to win?
Good one, this Oscar McDonald. That is. Melbourne haven't won consecutive games, two in a row, during a season since rounds 13 and 14 in 2011, which is unbelievable. Jack Watts, he's back in town, which is fantastic to see. And with that midfield that you've got, Bern, Viney, Jones, Oliver and Brayshaw, they're all hard as cat's heads. That is a good, tough midfield. That'll get them over the line and beat Essendon pretty easy.
Yeah. Well, no, they're taking on a couple of my old teammates. Good to see Matty Stokes and James Kelly get their hands on the ball last week. Yeah. Darcy Parrish was a good find for the Bombers too. Obviously picked up early in the draft. But I think Melbourne are going to be too strong.
In fact, credit to both recruiting groups, actually, and list managers, because not only did Darcy Parrish dominate for the Bombers in his debut and was fantastic, but as Bill said, Clayton Oliver, who was a bit of a smoky in the draft, has come in and played beautifully for you.
Yeah, I think he was a bit of a bolter in the draft, late mover, but yeah, he's been fantastic since coming in. Allergic to sand, I think. Hates sand in his feet. So really? That's an interesting fact about him anyway. But yeah, we've made it public. We've tried to recruit competitors and that's...
Show Bernie, please.
And allergic to sand.
I don't know if he's allergic. Doesn't enjoy it.
Oh, who do you think's going to win here, Forrest?
Melbourne are going to win. Don't boo every week, mate, because Essendon won't win a game.
They will.
I want to pose this question to you and you people watching. Would you think there is an incredible double standard regarding what Essendon have allegedly done? This is in the spate of the recent illicit drug takers. This is the definition of drug. Any substance intended to affect the structure of any function of the human body. Despite the blather from the unwashed, Essendon have not been proven to have done anything illegal yet. So what they've been charged is comfortable satisfaction. AWADA thinks they've been comfortably satisfied that they've done something wrong.
But the whole of the clubs in this competition have at least one player that has proven to have taken illicit drugs. They are performance enhancing. Illicit drugs quash your appetite, they improve your skin fold, and they make you train harder. Just ask Ben Cousins. If that is not an incredible double standard where people who have been proven to have taken illicit drugs, as opposed to Essendon, who have been proven to have done nothing, if that is not the greatest kangaroo court in the history of Australian sport, I don't know what is.
We started, Bill, this footy show year with the great hope that we'd never hear Sam speak about it.
Well, you never will.
And when's the rant back? Oh, the rant.
And when people... I see...
You're not going again.
What about Clive Evatt, Justice Clive Evatt, who went on behalf of Stephen Dank, sued a Sydney newspaper and was won the case for slander and libel? What does that tell you?
What it tells us is that Sportsbet, our great friends, have a head-to-head bet this weekend. I've been telling you about these for a while, and if you are into this, Willis, it is unbelievable. If your team lead at any break, but going to lose the match, Sportsbet will give you your cash back up to $50. That's cold hard into your account if your team lose after leading at any change. Five of the games last week this occurred. 17,000 customers got their cash back. To get involved, download the app today. And please remember always to gamble responsibly. We must also recognise a great friend of ours on the footy show, BJ Goddard. He and his beautiful partner had a lovely little girl, Billy, during the week, everybody. Yes. Billy Rose.
Billy Rose. Well done to BJ, of course, and well done to Rosie, his partner, and that is fantastic. What a lovely name Billy is. Now, Bernie, you say some silly things like you want to sing Sweet Home Alabama, but also...
Alabama.
Yeah, I know what it is, Dopey. Do you really want to keep Jesse Hogan? Have a listen to this.
He loves it around the place, and he's contracted for next year still, so I think he'd be silly to sign now. Might be able to squeeze a bit more money out of the club if he has another good year. So I can see why they've done it and why his management have decided that. So hopefully they don't take any money off me, though. I haven't got much left at the moment.
Oh, Ben.
Well, I 100% take that back. I got spoken to the next day by the media manager, Todd Viney, Josh Marnie.
Peter
and
Jackson.
I'd like him to sign now for minimum chips.
And you got a shout-out too, Nana Vince.
I have, yeah. She... Nana Rosemary at home. Hello, Nana. She's 80 today, so happy birthday at home. I think all the ladies from the bowls club went up to her house and surprised her, so I think they might still be partying on or asleep.
Nice.
and we should say at 12:34... the Essendon fans will be marching from the Federation Square to the MCG 12:34 because there's 34 players suspended.
And you will be there?
And I will be there. Walking. And my son Max will be there because he's an Essendon supporter. We'll be walking in protest of the deal they've been given.
12:34 Essendon fans from Fed Square to the MCG for this Ripper match. Hey, the newsbreaker extraordinaire has been in very, very nice form at the start of the season. Put your hands together for Damien Barrett.
Thank you, Joe. And we'll start with a story involving Sam's new favourite club, Essendon. That club's concerns over Michael Hurley continue to amount, and that's because he's been a noticeable absentee from the training sessions that have been attended by most of his WADA band teammates in recent times. That group has been training up to four times a week. Hurley has been choosing to not attend those group sessions. And the Bombers, while they're not allowed to have official contact with him, they are aware of his absence from those sessions, as are other footy clubs. Hurley is contracted for 2017, but should he choose to go down this path, he will have legal passage to leave the club, given the club's admission of guilt in the recent occupational health and safety case that was heard. Michael Hibbert has also been missing those sessions, but we believe the reasoning for that has been because of travel as opposed to disillusionment. We'll stick with the banned players for a moment. St Kilda's multi-million dollar investment in Jake Carlisle is continuing to unearth problems. We know that the Vegas issues, we know of the 12-month ban he's received. We now know, and St Kilda now knows, that they've inherited a player with a very serious hip complaint. He had the hip operated on 10 days ago, but
What happened when the surgeons got into the particular problem? They realised the problem was greater than they first thought. Upshot is, in footy terms, this injury now is a 14-week setting aside, and he would have effectively missed more than half the season had he had it done in this season anyway. It was something that he did carry throughout last year at his time at Essendon, and may well have explained some of his disappointment with some actions of the footy club at that time. On to Lockie Whitfield, the number one draft picks from some years ago at GWS. Offers have come flooding for him from all clubs around the country. The GWS team, though, now is of the belief that it has fought off those offers, very confident of retaining him, hoping to make that official sometime in the next 3 to 4 weeks. And Wayne Campbell, who now leaves a massive gaping hole in the AFL umpiring department, leaving there to go and work with GWS in the football department. Expect that Luke Ball, the former St Kilda Best and Fairest winner, St Kilda captain, and also Collingwood Premier, ship player, will be playing a key role in whatever structure the AFL puts around Wayne Campbell's absence there in the umpiring department.
All right, thanks for that, Damo. Very nice as always.
Well done, Damo.
Now, Sam.
Yes.
It's my understanding that you and the great team that look after Street Talk went and filmed our first for the year.
We did. We went up to Quambatook to the tractor pull. And it was fantastic up there. Very nice country folk up there.
Yes.
They might be a bit nonplussed at some of the people we put on, but they were just the locals. Bit of colour and movement at the tractor pull. And as you would imagine, Jim, a lot of innuendo and double entendres.
Was there?
You can have a full pull, a total pull, a successful pull. You can have a half pull,
right.
And did they jump right into that particular line of chat with us?
Bring some merchandise.
Yes, we bought a T-shirt home. I was presented with this. I'm sorry, I'm glad Rebecca's not here.
Oh, yeah.
This was just what they were had on. I pulled myself stupid.
Yeah, well.
that was what was on sale at the actual Quambatook tractor pull, and very nice place up there, Jim.
Well,
people would put 100,000 horsepower engines in tractors and try and pull a sled full of concrete over a dirt surface, I don't know. But it was exciting to watch for about a minute.
We have.
And it was fantastic. We had a great time up there and very, very nice folk.
We actually have a little tease of what you're going to see next week. We'll show you the complete item. But here's a little of our man up at Quambatook.
Pull a sled down 100 metre track, and if you go out the end, it's a full pull.
A full pull?
And then you got to go back for a pull off.
I pulled myself. It's a bit of a double entendre, that, isn't it?
Yeah.
Meant to be.
Bit of a gimmick.
Puma took out to be a hick town.
What?
This is my 30 seconds of fame. And you caught me. I've never been more pissed than this before, and you've caught me on live television.
You get excited by it when you're...
Yeah, I'm petrolhead from way back.
Are you? You ever driven a tractor?
Yes, I have.
You love
what
you see, Sam. Oh, a bit of plonk.
Something, mate, big pull going on down there at the minute, mate. The sound of the engine?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, what is that?
It's a big one.
This could be a good area for a boutique stadium. Can you spell the word boutique?
B. Oh.
I actually won the Australian Championship for the spelling bee.
Did you?
Nah. F***ing hell of shit, mate.
Shit. No.
Bullshit.
You're putting on a bit of weight. You're putting on a bit of weight there.
You're coming for a ride in spot on until we're
all set. I am.
Yes, you are.
You like to see me scared shitless.
I do, because I see you on the footy show and I want to see you this scared.
Why am I doing this?
To do mailbag at your event, it's pretty simple. streettalk@nine.com.au. We have had thousands of requests for you.
Couldn't put a lot more on. We have to get quite a bit of it legaled for next week, so we'll show the rest of it there. We're just going through the motions of getting it cleared.
Well, if you want the great man, there it is, streettalk@nine.com.au. We are heading to a break, but there is a mountain still to climb on this show. Don't worry. Best in Footy show not far away. Sam's mailbag not far away. But next, as I said, the legend from St Kilda, Nick Riebolt.
Most about it. Rui was his insatiable appetite for information, just wanting to learn as much as he could about the game, and very, very intense and passionate about himself. We talked about being a pro's pro at that stage. No one who played with him could ever say that he didn't give 100% for the cause, and not many players can say they gave 100% 100% of the time.
Oh, it's a great kick! Superlative stuff from the skipper. He's got four, and he is leading from the front.
Nick's qualities as a captain, and I think we've seen it over a long period of time, is one, he doesn't ask anything of anyone else that he wouldn't do himself. He's ultra competitive, and that's exactly what he expects from his teammates.
Look out! Oh, Riebolt, remarkable!
Well, every time I see it, it makes me afraid. The willingness to just put yourself in a position of extreme danger, it just gets me every time.
I just think that sums up Nick as a person, as a player, and probably sums up his whole career. He just goes to the ball. He sees it, he jumps at it, and anything in between he'll take out.
The blue runs onto it. Can he ice it? The captain put him in the prelim.
His will to win and his determination. You know, he sometimes embarrassed his teammates in their actions with how hard he's gone about his football and what he'd do for the team to win. So we've been very lucky to play with such a special player.
Oh, that's a brilliant goal from Nick Riebolt. Nothing but Nick.
Loose ball. Guess who? It's only fitting.
Universally admired Nick Riebolt, and for very good reason. His numbers are extraordinary. A six-time Best and Fairest winner at the St Kilda Football Club, a five-time All-Australian, and on the weekend he plays game number 300. Put your hands together for a champion of our game, Nick Riebolt. Games. When you started off, did you ever think your career would have that sort of longevity?
Oh, absolutely not. I remember in my first year, Nathan Burke and Stewie Lowe played their 300th game, and I remember obviously thinking what great St Kilda legends they were, and also just how old they were. And now to be in that position, I don't feel old. I don't feel like that's sort of my place in the game. But look, it's a great honour, and also played a lot of footy with halves who played well over 300, so to be joining those guys is why it's so satisfying, I guess, personally.
And Sam always points out that it's very rare for a big man to play 300 games. Often they're the smaller type players, but you know, for your height and the way you've banged yourself up, as Sam did too, it is a great tribute to you. You must be really pleased personally.
Yeah, absolutely. It's you know, it's obviously a really special honour, and this week as well to be doing it. In conjunction with Matty's vision, something that's really close to my heart, it's going to be a really special night. So I'm just looking forward to enjoying it with my family and with my teammates.
Well, we just saw a couple of your former teammates and current teammates and your coach, of course, Grant Thomas, talk about you. Before we get stuck into this game and what the night's going to mean to you and your family, had some really special people who wanted to give you a message, Rui, in the build-up to this game. These are two massive St Kilda fans. Enjoy this.
Nick is one of those people that never, ever complains or ever tries to show an injury. He plays on regardless of what, you know, and it's been a wonderful 300 games, not only for yourself and for the family, but for us as St Kilda supporters, because it's been an absolute delight watching you. They're well done. Love you, Nick, and be proud, and your family as well.
Congratulations on your 300th game. You really have been magnificent for the St Kilda Football Club, but even better than that,
You've been a great ambassador for the game of AFL football, and I think a lot of people and a lot of clubs would love to have you on their side. Knowing you as a friend, mate, it's been fantastic to call you a friend, and I look forward to many more times, whether you're bowling your left arm spinners down the sideway in the driveway, or we're kicking the footy down the park. Good luck this weekend. I hope it goes great. Keep up the great work with Matty's vision, and all the best in your 300th game. Hats off.
Very special. As you say, two legends in their own right, of course, and massive Saints fans. We need to say thanks very much to Shane Warne, Sam, who is actually in India, yep, and requested that he be part of tonight for you, Rui, so we had to organise a camera crew to get to him, but that's how special it is for him. Hey, you spend a lot of your pre-seasons now in Waco, Texas.
Yep.
You would be pretty much the only footballer of the 850 who do a pre-season on your own overseas. Tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, well, I think I'm the poster boy at the moment. I know Sel and Hodgie and a few of the boys at the Captain's Day the other week were getting stuck into me, making sure I have a really good start to the season, because then all the other senior players can say, hey, we're going to come back after Christmas as well. So it's great. It's been really refreshing for me to have the opportunity to spend time overseas, to mix the training up, and also for Kath and her family to spend time over there. So I really enjoyed it. I've got a gym there that I go to. The big 300-pound African-American guys had to tell me to put some shorts on over my running tights and a bit of that sort of stuff and keep the junk out of their face. But it's been really enjoyable. I've really loved it.
Thinks he's half American or Texan, don't you? And it's a celebration for your family. Obviously a sad day also, Nick, but a celebration for your family and Maddie's vision. And this is Mum here and your little fella, of course, James at Etihad. And there's Kath there. So that's what it's all about. Your dad there too, mate?
Yeah, it's a really emotional week for us as a family, but we're in a really fortunate position that we're able to leverage this occasion and raise some money for Matty's vision. And really for me and for the rest of the family, the only thing missing from Saturday night will be Matty in a physical sense, but in this way we get to honour her and her legacy. And emotionally and spiritually, she'll be a really big part of the night, so that'll be great.
I feel like I took advantage of the organisation. You gave me a pair of briefs, budgie smugglers, yeah. And I wore them over in South Africa. I was over on safari there, and this was me lying just with the zwelt in the background, the savannah land, that was me diving into the pool at the Singita Lodge over in Kruger National Park, so... I had the memory of you and her over there with me.
I appreciate that. Oh, she'd be wrapped.
Spreading the message. Had you just pulled an elephant skin over yourself? Or what was on the lilo there for?
What was on the lilo?
Yeah.
What, I'd missed the lilo.
Hey, we'll get stuck into the game and then we'll talk a lot more about what's happening on Saturday night, because some terrific things are. But Bernard, I think you've got this game. It's going to be a big one too. The Saints and the Doggies.
I have, mate. Obviously a big game for both teams this weekend. Out for the Saints, Templeton and Akers, both omitted. Into the side comes number one draft pick and Paddy McCartan.
Paddy.
He's back, so moving on to the Bulldogs there. They've gone in unchanged. No changes there, obviously coming off a great win and sort of shocked the footy world, I think, last weekend with their win over Fremantle. So looking forward to seeing them again.
No.
The Saints very good off the back of, for three quarters against Port Adelaide, a very good side. The Western Bulldogs have won 10 in a row at Etihad, so they'll be hard to beat.
Now, Tom Hickey was outstanding last week for the Saints. They were good, but you always got to go with the Doggies at Etihad. Do yourself a favour, as Molly would say, and pick the Doggies always at Etihad. Foss?
Now we say there's no such thing as milestone games, Jim. The boys don't play any harder for any particular cause at all. But beware. If you were being credible, you wouldn't pick the Saints to beat Footscray in the way they're playing. Mm. But... We don't hope St Kilda win, because that means we hope Footscray lose. But I will tip the Western Bulldogs. Wouldn't be disappointed at all to have that particular tip wrong.
Appreciate it.
Yes, thank you, Nick.
Rui, Grant Thomas mentioned in the interview just before about your extraordinary courage, especially the bit of vision we saw when you went back with the flight against Sydney, and that's been played 1,000 times. When you look back on that now, are you thinking, what the hell was I thinking?
Well, what I was thinking was Robert Harvey had the ball and I just had such trust in halves that I knew wherever he kicked it, I could not possibly get hurt. So when he kicked it, I just put my head down and went for it because I knew halves liked to look after me. But poor old Milne coming the other way, he almost got on the wrong end of it. But Mum got on the phone after the game and basically told me if I ever did that again, she'd stop watching and stop coming to games. So I haven't done anything silly like that since.
Now, you could have, if you hadn't taken football on as a vocation, I know this for a fact because two world-renowned athletes put this out in the public arena, that they said you could have been a world champion 400-metre runner. That is correct, isn't it? Who were those two people? I'll give you a hint. Daly Thompson.
Daly and... was it Seb?
Sebastian Coe.
Sorry.
Said if you ever stop playing football or even if you didn't start, come over, we'll make you the best 400-metre runner in the world.
Is that right?
Well, they said that. They said that.
Oh, I think I made a pretty good choice playing footy. It's a pretty lonely existence being an athlete and I've enjoyed the team atmosphere of playing footy and, yeah, I think I made the right choice.
Now, this is a generic question and it's one that can be easily just dismissed because you can give a glib answer. Looking back, could you or the side have done any more to have more success? What was the most disappointing period of your 300 games? Not that you finished playing yet. You might end up snaring the cup by the end of the year. But what was the most disappointing part of it that you thought you could have prevailed and didn't?
Yeah, well, obviously you're alluding to the grand finals and that would be the most disappointing part, I think, of anyone's career when you play in a losing grand final. So upon reflection, there's not much more from a preparation or an effort point of view that we could have done to come out on top in those games. They were both incredibly close games. We could have just executed better at times, but no one goes into games to make mistakes and my head rests on the pillow pretty comfortably knowing all the work that went in, all the effort that went in and, you know, all the work that was done game day. No one shirked an issue, no one pulled out of a contest. Everyone played as hard as they could. We just didn't execute as well as we would have liked.
Well, I'll tell you what, if anyone's earned the right to rest easy on the pillow, Rui, it's yourself. Let's talk about what's happening Saturday night because it's a big night. Maddie's match, $5, I think, from every ticket. Is that how it works?
Yeah, $5 from every ticket from walk-up at the gate. We'll come back to Maddie's vision, which is great. We really appreciate the support there. There'll be plenty of activation as well around the ground, merchandise available, and also...
Raffle?
Raffle, yeah. Get onto mrv.org.au and... For every $25 contribution, you go in the draw to win a $23,000 APT package to the Kimberleys, and there's about 100 other great prizes as well.
All right. Well, Force, maybe you can dust off 25 on behalf of the Footy Show.
If you just leave another pair of budgie smugglers at the desk on the way out, mate, I'm thinking of going overseas again
easy
next
fixed.
Year. I don't have to buy any. Just be happy to
win. You're an XL, weren't you?
Speaking of the merchandise, tip your hat is, of course, a big part of it. So the boys have got the hats on there. What else you got there, Bernd?
I got the Guernsey, Rui's Guernsey this weekend, so...
There we go.
12 in the back.
Beautiful.
Don't know much about it.
No, but that's all right. That's Rui. It says Rui 300.
It's got the Maddie's Vision logo on the back, so a percentage of sales from that.
What I'd do advise you, Benny, I'd get him to sign it and then quickly get onto eBay with
it. Yeah, I might keep that, actually.
And the tip your hats, of course, Jimmy Boy, in honour of the great St Nick here. And this is the AFL players tipping their hats, which is fantastic. There he is, the great banger, Rossline. $5 these hats are for members. There's Ivy.
There are the captains from earlier in the year. That's fantastic.
Yeah. Oh, $10 for non-members. Jack. Oh, is that James? How long did that take?
One take.
Yeah, those guys.
Clever kid.
$5 for members and $10 for non-members. And Rui will sign them all. He loves that. Come up and ask for it, he'll sign them all.
Thanks, Billy. Appreciate that.
When you look back, you must have so many people you want to thank. Not that this is a winning Brownlow medal speech or whatever, but to achieve what you've achieved, there must have been so many people along the way that have helped you be the footballer you are.
Yeah, it's incredible. When you've been involved in a footy club for the amount of time that I've been involved at the one club especially, you come across so many great people, and that's what I'll take from footy. If I eventually retire without a premiership, the one thing that I will really treasure is the relationships and the friendships that I've been able to form over a long period of time. And they're far-reaching, and at a time like this over the past 12 months, it's been really challenging for our family to be embraced the way we have by the entire football community, not just St Kilda people, but doesn't matter what club they've come from, has been really touching. So From our family and from everyone at Matty's Vision, we thank you from the bottom of our hearts for the support.
It's brilliant. And post this match, mate, you can lie very comfortably with the thought that every time there's a 300-game get-together, you can run into the old enforcer.
Yeah, I look forward to that. That's right. Great.
You want to get there early.
Hey, make sure, speaking of getting there early, make sure you get along Saturday night. It is the Western Bulldogs and St Kilda, two great sides to watch, by the way, at Etihad. And if you get along, you will anyway, mrv.org.au to get behind this amazing cause. $5 from every ticket will go to Matty's Vision, which is absolutely fantastic. A lot to be enormously proud of. Good luck Saturday night. Thanks very much for
coming in.
Nick Leibold, we're going to a break. When we come back, Sam's Mailbag will be next. Welcome back to the Footy Show. Thanks to Nissan, of course. Home Timber and Hardware, go where the tradies go. And sportsbet.com.au. Speaking of our great friends, of course, at Nissan, their tipping comp is underway, but it is not too late to enter. Not only can you win a magnificent NP300 Navara, we've been telling you about that, also weekly prizes of cold, hard cash to be won. Here's how you get involved.
Thanks to Nissan, our top tipster at the end of the season will win an NP300 Navara. That's over 50k worth of tough Nissan motor vehicle. There are also four runner-up prizes of flights, accommodation and tickets to the Grand Final Footy Show. Plus weekly prizes of $500 cash to be won. Head to wideworldofsports.com.au/tipping for full T's and C's and to get your tips in now.
Yes, thanks to Nissan. The NP300 Navara, very much worth winning.
Tipping.
Before we get to that, Bill, spoke to Nick Riewoldt before, what a superstar that man is, about Shane Warne and how from India he wanted to get involved. But what about the great Molly Meldrum?
Yes.
How good did Molly look?
Well done, Molly.
There is a star. And a very, very passionate saint and a very good friend of all of ours. It's great to see Molly looking so good. Yes, the tipping, Bill. Why are you mentioning that?
Well, I tipped 9 last week, so I'm leading the tipping comp with amongst us. Sam, you got 6, Crawl 6, and James, you got 7. So, well done, Wilbur. Top of the ladder again.
Interesting, given I don't actually tip. You've got the game, Bill.
I have. What about this? This is showdown number 40. Adelaide take on Port Adelaide. And Adelaide lost last week to North Melbourne. Pretty good game. And big Jerker Jenkins kick 5 as one change there. Hardigan in. Van Berlow gets dropped, which is quite interesting. Daniel Talia plays his 100th game. Taya Gunn, the mighty Port Adelaide, who won by 33 points last week. They only did it in the last quarter. And unfortunately, Matty White's out for 10 weeks with that pectoral. And Tump, the Tumpus is back, which is fantastic. First time last week, under Ken Hinckley, Port Adelaide have had 100 tackles. First time ever. There you go. There's a hashtag fat guts or whatever it is. Fat stat. So, having said that, toss of the coin, I'm going with Port Adelaide, Jolly.
Yeah, both sides very impressive last week. I'm going to go with Port Adelaide too. Robbie Gray, very impressive. Very impressive last week. 26 possessions, 4 goals. Good way to start.
Yeah, I liked Adelaide North Melbourne last week. One of the best games to watch of the round. Mm. And that's why I reckon Adelaide will win this week. Big Tex taking 10 grabs and kicking a couple of goals, I reckon we'll get him over the line.
What about your former teammate and now the Geelong Flyer, Paddy Dangerfield, after Victoria beat South Australia in the Shield final, just tweeting out, Vicks do it better. Yeah, it's had a savage reaction in South Australia.
I do follow the cricket, though, and that's their hashtag. Yeah. So that's Vicks do it better. Whenever
yeah, no one in South Australia
update.
Gives a stuff about that.
No, I don't think Twitter. Twitter hasn't made it to Adelaide yet, I don't think. But, yeah.
Good win by the Vicks. By
no, very good win. Yeah. They deserved winners on the road, yeah. Sadly, against my boys. Yes.
No, I like Adelaide to win.
Do you?
No idea why.
We spoke about Mars matchups. We're going to have a look at this on the screen now. Last week, the Adelaide Derby, as we like to call it, Matthew Lobe against Sam Jacobs, the two big ruckmen, of course. Also, yes. You got Adam Treloar and Dusty Martin.
Inside
massive
50s.
Game Friday night, inside 50. Thank you, Bill. Nick Riewoldt, the man we just saw with Jake Stringer.
Marks.
What about those two big boys? And then Nate Fyfe and Gary Ablett, Bill?
Disposals, Jim.
Disposals. Yeah. Mars matchups. .com.au is how you get stuck into
the
that.
Chemistry's back.
Chemistry, Willis. As always, chemistry attached to this segment, a Footy Show favourite, a staple, in fact. Sam's Mailbag.
I've got a FOSS fact for you.
Have you?
Do you know this is true? Do you know why Nissan race their cars and they have 23 as a number, usually if it's available?
Right, why?
Because 2 in Japanese is Ni, and 3 in Japanese is Sun, so Nissan.
Oh, that's it.
That's right. That's what they do.
Nice, a nice FOSS fact. Yeah. All right, the old...
The Nissan people here had no idea about that. This is from Cole of Hand Off.
Hand Off. It's a beautiful town in the Adelaide Hills, Harndorf.
Hand, right then. Yep. Handoff, right. Mm-hmm. Hey.
With a dog.
Yes.
You idiot.
What was that?
Oh.
Hey, Fossil, get any Easter eggs. How was your Easter? Well, better than this guy's.
Somebody going to stand on an egg.
Yes.
I was on my way to visit me mum, says Cole of Handoff. I was on my way to visit me mum at Wedderburn near Bendigo, and you barged past me at the Caltex servo and started washing your smalls in the sink. What was going on there?
Oh, no.
Well, I did have an incident
did
there,
you?
Which the crew thought was vaguely humorous.
What Jim? Happened?
Well, would you believe it? I've got some dim sims and the Worcestershire sauce has leaked.
Oh, don't.
Yeah. I'll be back.
Yeah. Look at the bikies.
Sammy shit himself.
No, appreciate that. No, it wasn't quite. It looked like it. It was the Worcestershire sauce from the dim sims.
Sammy shit himself.
Stupid dumb bikers.
Mate,
and everything stuck. I don't know if we could do this if Rebecca was here. But everything stuck. Have we ever got Worcestershire sauce in any of the plums?
Never have.
Mate, everything stuck to everything. And why didn't you go to Adelaide International Kite Festival on the long weekend? Are you scared you're not welcome in South Australia? Now, Shane is the only one that's scared that he's not welcome there.
I've got to time something with me going out to see my 90-year-old mother.
Oh, do you want to send a cheerio to her?
No, I'd like you to f*** off.
Yes.
Now, this is from Noah of Tullamarine.
Oh, no.
That's it.
Newman. If ever there was a man that needs a drug... Newman, if ever there's a man that needs drug testing, it would be this man here.
Oh. What is that?
His name... I think that's the dog's tail. His name is Ivan.
Yes.
He is from Belarus and he wants to perform his Eurovision song naked alongside two live wolves. This is true.
No way.
True.
Yes.
What would that man be doing in Eurovision?
The Belarusian.
Stark naked with two wolves snapping at his agates. What is? Does that give you any ideas for the player of you, Sam? With the drug saga, you blokes should do a funny regular sketch about it. It could be funny as. Does anyone remember this?
Yes, the Bulger.
Maybe we could reboot it and have it look like this, Jimmy.
James Brayshaw, you're a flog.
Oh, no.
I actually don't understand any of that.
You haven't seen Breaking Bad?
No, I have not. What is Breaking Bad?
One of the most successful television shows ever made.
What is it about?
About a man who thought he was going to pass away, so he decided that in his last minutes alive, he'd become a drug manufacturer and salesman.
Wow. Haven't got his address, have you?
No.
Doug, this is from Doug of Dandenong.
Here we are at the new Dandenong Plaza.
Come on,
Sam. Lovejoy's. Now, we had Sam Lovejoy's Sportsman's Night story last week about Andrew Purser and the sex tape. Andrew wrote in.
Did
and
he?
It actually just confirmed that that
what
was
happened?
True and.
Yeah.
Said, yeah, no, he did. Yeah. If you were ever after a cracking after dinner speaker, you could do a lot worse than warn his old mate Graham Gooch.
There he is,
Goochie.
I know you've had a warny on the show, but ever had Gooch? Well, we've had a different, not the Graham. We've had
right.
a different kind
style
of Gooch.
Of.
I'm not sure if we could do this if this was next week. No. We've had a different kind of Gooch
right.
on, haven't we?
What's the most unusual body piercing part you've had to actually attend to, sir?
A Gooch.
A what's it?
A Gooch in between the nutsack and your butthole.
That is the most tenuous link. Oh, yes. Right.
I think we got it in. Just,
oh, did we?
We got it in this week. I don't think we could have done it.
That's called a crowbarring.
I tell you who I am not a big fan of. Your mate Bernie Vince.
Oh, there he is.
Mr. Vince asked me and my mate to be in the background of some dumb karaoke skit.
Yes.
He was filming at Burnley Golf Course. He then swung past and nicked my mate's ball.
For the rest of your days, it's a rolling free.
Oh,
Jesus.
My
last
of me. Oh.
Cool.
Oh,
where did I throw his ball?
If you want to be a part of this award-winning segment, it's not hard. Sam's Mailbag, GPO Box 9, Melbourne, Victoria 3001. Sam's got mailbag at 9.com.au. or 9now.com.au/AFL/footy/show. Bill?
Boom, we're not far away. You're ready to go. The band's firing up there. Yeah. Ready to go. Yeah. Because if, Boom, you don't do it, guess who wants to do it?
Fast,
here it is. Come on, Boom.
Nah, not
Come
yet.
Come on.
Not yet.
Come on.
Nah, not at
all. Fossil, you want to go, Foss? Oh, look at him. Come on, Boom.
Make sure you're watching the Footy Show next week. Of course, this lady is an absolute star. We can't wait to have her on board. Beck Madden, highly anticipated Footy Show debut. Get excited about that. She'll be unbelievably good. We also got a huge panel next week. Trav Cloak from the Pies will be joining us live, of course, as will Joey Montagna from the Saints. There's your panel. That'll be a beauty. Plenty more with the Force heading up to Quambatook. Street Talk returns and plenty to get excited about for the Footy Show next week. Nice game, Bill, up in Brisbane.
Huge game at the Gabba, Jim. It's Brisbane taking on North Melbourne. And Brisbane were all right last week. They scored over 100 points, got beaten. And a couple of changes there. Robinson out, Freeman and Paparone. In comes Merritt, Zorko and Green. Three good ones there. And for North Melbourne, Jed Anderson with a hammy. Shut up. Jed Anderson goes out for 10 weeks with a hammy. Kane Turner comes in. And a fat stat here, Jimmy boy.
Yes, please.
North Melbourne have only won once at the Gabba since 2005. A bit of a danger game for North Melbourne.
Don't be bringing negative stuff up.
I'm not.
Glass half empty.
But I love Todd, and Todd will get you over the line. He was outstanding last week. North Melbourne.
Very good.
Aeroplane Joe.
Not a bad step.
North Melbourne just too healthy at the moment. I think they've got 44 out of possible 46 players that are up and playing, so I think that they'll run away with the win.
Bernard?
Yes. Yeah, I like the look of Josh Sash, the high draft pick, come in last week for his first game.
Shacky.
But,
Shacky.
Is that how you say it?
What do you call it?
Sash.
It's phonetically Sash, but it's Shacky.
Yep.
Thanks, Bill. Anyway, Who do they play? North Melbourne. Well, as I said before, one of the best games of the round, that game, so I think North Melbourne will be too strong.
I am of the opinion, Jim, that the Kangaroos are the most honest side in the competition. They give every week. And no thanks to you, I'm just saying that. That is, they give great value for money, the Kangaroos, and I think they'll probably beat the Lions up there at the game.
The Best in Footy show has been going for the last 3 weeks, and we have reached the crescendo, of course. This is the time trial. This is the final act. But here are the standings after the first two challenges. We can see Josh Gibson and Zeus out in front of Chrissy Dawes, Dane Swan, Brendan Goddard, David Armitage, and poor old Rock, Tommy Rockliffe, came down with his Dachshund and had an absolute nightmare. But I'm telling you this much, those positions are not assured because, as I say, this is the time trial. Best in Footy show, Best in Footy show, challenge three, enjoy.
Challenge three, time trial.
Difficult for a Dachshund, I'd imagine. He's got to get over that jump. Oh, he's gone around. Righto. Oh, yeah. Nice. Righto. This is good.
Treats,
come. Such a low hurdle for a big dog. Oh, no. The first jump. Come on. There we are, little move. There, good one. Here we go. Oh, no, it's just barged on through. It's all right, the tunnel of love. It's stumped all of our dogs. Zeus! Zeus! Oh, Zeus!
Lex, Lex.
Do you go, Josh? Go,
oh,
Josh.
No.
Get in there, go. In there. Hop in there. Come on, come
Many
on.
Many times you've been through the tunnel of love, Gibbo.
Look at silly shot. Look at that moron.
That's it. Oh, microphone gone, armour. Oh, no. He's lost his microphone and his dog. Chuck the dog into the chute. It's working its way through. Rock, get down the other end. Nicely done. All right, again, just placed on the ramp as the dog heads up. Not keen on that at all. Keep going, Rock.
Up.
Here it is.
Up.
Here it is.
Here. Here, Lex. Oh. Lex. Lex.
It's all about time, Armour. Get him back in the lead. Armour, you can use the lead on the ramp if you need to.
It's okay, it's okay.
Just keep holding, Dawes. March the dog the whole way along. That's very nice. And keep going. Very good. That's it. Every now and then, touch the pads on the ramp. There we are. Oh, very good. Let's go. Oh, put it right at the top. That's right. That's it, Bud. Keep going down. Keep going down, Bud. Oh!
Barney.
The old face plant. Now frighten the cardboard dogs. Come on.
Lex. Lex.
Righto, oh, work its way through the blind chute.
Right, bro. Come on.
He's lost his dog in the blind chute. Time ticking away, Dawsa.
That's it. Just wait.
All right. Come on, Brett. That's it. It's all about time, Armour, so let's go. Good. No. Zeus is stinking it right up.
Come on. Go in there. Go in there.
Nothing. Oh, it's dragging it on, Lex. The dog ain't coming out of there. There we are, now just the old carry trail. A minute 37, over the jump it goes. Through the final hoop, that's it. Ah, oh, very nice finish. Get it around, that's it. Oh, nice. And then a forceful start, but that's good. All right, run around, hold it. And there we go. 2 minutes. Up onto the podium. Let's get to our judges. Steph, firstly for you, what were your thoughts?
We've just got a bit of a problem. I'm a bit concerned. It was definite intent to bribe the judges by dressing up the dog.
That is true.
And, so I'm really sorry, but it's no score.
No score? Oh, he spat at Rock. He's off. He's charged out of the arena.
Come on, bud.
bullshit.
I have a feeling we might have a ring in.
What do you got there, Shane?
Jim, I have been into Dorsey's room.
Uh-oh.
And he has two docks.
No.
Yes. We've got a fine cotton.
So, Chris, is there any truth in the fact that you swapped docks?
I've never seen him before. He was no good anyway.
He's throwing his other dog under the bus. What sort of penalty are we imposing on this man for swapping his dogs?
Well, it has to be a DQ.
A DQ? Another one?
Yes.
So the final tally, Tommy Rockliffe and Killer and, of course, Dawes are out. BJ, fourth. David Armitage, third. Dane Swan, second, which leaves Force. Our winner, Josh Gibson and Zeus. 39 points. And he then was the recipient of the bowler. Fantastic performance. He gets to go on the bowler. What about the performance?
Zeus there, and we asked Gibbo to send some photos in and have a look. He's very happy, Zeus. There he is there. Very happy with the bone load. Oh, look at that one. That's for you, Sam. Just have a look out there. But well done. And we must thank Gibbo, BJ, Dorsey, Tom Rockliffe, Armour and Swanee,
yep,
who are fantastic.
They were.
And their dogs are really, really good. And our very good sponsors, Home Timber and Hardware. Go where the tradies go. There's the table there. But they helped us out with that one there, Jimmy boy. And
they did.
It was a bit of fun, wasn't it?
It was. Yeah. It was very nice and great sports, everyone involved, including our special comments man and, of course, also the judge.
Very
special comments man say much?
Yeah, not
much. No, he didn't say a lot. Brevity of words, but that's all he's meant to judge, not talk about it.
Now,
and all the best to Dane Swan, of course, who now will be able to teach his dog some new tricks because he'll have some time off. Yeah. So all the best to
Swanee. We do wish Swanee well. Hey, we need to get to a break because what we've been doing since the start of this year in the Footy Show is getting our audience, live audience, to write down a question they've always wanted to ask Sam Newman. It's called What the Foss? Sam doesn't see any of the questions. Bernie Vince, Joel Selwood and Bill Brownless will read the questions out on the crowd members' behalf. That is coming up, and it cannot be missed.
Welcome back to the Footy Show, and local footy is back, so is almost footy legend Bernie. So get your camera, your video camera, and get out there and take some of these. These are the best from last year. Kangaroo Flat versus Sandhurst. And what about that jump from Braden Knox? Have a look at Knoxy here. Turns in the air and lands on his bum.
Fair grab, Bill. Yes. Fair grab. I've got old Trinity and old Scotch here. Great tap down on the wing.
Oh.
And nice finish. But watch the kid behind the goals, Bill.
Oh, no.
Keep your eye on the ball. Oh, that's on cement too.
There it is there. Bang.
Oh, eyes on it. Oh.
And I love this one. This one won it last year. This is all from last year. Flagstaff Hill versus Brighton. Have a look at Madjock here. He gets it. One, he's kicked it off the ground. It's wet conditions. He goes again. Two off the ground.
Not again.
Yeah, don't tell me. Bernie, three.
Oh,
three
not
times.
Again. Go no, he goes again.
Madjock, four times. And goes back.
Brilliant.
Well done, Madjock. That one last year, the best prizes in town. Don't worry about this. So send them in because you could win this.
Thanks to Sportsbet, our weekly winner takes home $1,000 cash, while our runners-up get $500 each. Get involved this AFL season and make it a multi with Sportsbet. Thanks to Home Timber and Hardware, our major winner receives $5,000 in gift cards and a toolbox full of $45,000 in cold hard cash. That's a $50,000 prize. How's that to help you go hard towards the renovation you've always wanted? So to put the hard back into hardware, go where the tradies go. Home Timber and Hardware.
Exactly right, our very good friends at Home Timber and Hardware. Send your interest, almost footy legend, 2PO Box 9, Melbourne 3001, don't forget. You can upload your legends directly to our website. $50,000, Jim.
What about that?
$50,000.
Best prices in football.
So get out there, videotape it and send it in to us and we'll put you on TV.
That's it. All the kids' footy about to start, so make sure you take your video tape along, video camera along. Yes. Hey, Sel, what do you got there, please?
Mate, to help the kids out, a little device that Ross Faulkner and a good mate, Scotty Anderson from Bendigo.
What happens?
This is a one-touch football and been using it over the summer, been in rehab a little bit. But
how does it work?
It's just the simple one. I'll kick it to Foss and
he'll
come back.
That's not bad.
So you can have kick to kick with yourself.
It just sharpens up the skills and hands. I don't know how you'd go, Sammy, but...
Yeah, Foss, that's good. You should have put it on the front end.
All right, what's your Instagram account, Sel? You can check out.
Yeah, no, Joel Selwood 14 and a few little pictures up there, but Ross Faulkner. You can get on rossfaulkner.com and you'll find it under training equipment.
Very nice.
Not sad, Dad.
Keep,
I like that.
You like it, Force? Keep the games rolling. Frio play host to the Gold Coast Suns Domain Stadium. Massive for Fremantle. Got to bounce back. And speaking of massive, the axe has been swung by Ross Lyon, but they've got some huge ins. Of course, Sandilands enormous. Johnson's a very, very good player as well. Pierce and Langdon, Gold Coast, winners in round one. It's a big trip across to Domain Stadium. Rosa injured, making his way back home. And Collar Jasny comes in. But what about Gary Ablett? Just a supreme start, having played no football in the pre-season, Bill. He was unbelievable. Tough assignment. You'd expect Fremantle to be very, very good.
Oh, they bounce back. They've got to bounce back. They'd be angry and Roscoe Lyon will have them up and about and Fremantle will win this one. Jolly?
Yeah, no, definitely. They're hard to beat over there. Good to see Gaz come back and do what he does off the back of no pre-season games. But Fremantle are going to be hard to beat.
Burn.
Yeah, if Aaron Sandlin's back in, I think Freo would be too strong.
Samuel.
Yes, Gary was speaking of Gary's. Hello to Gary Lyon. Hope he's going well. We all hope that, don't we?
No doubt about that.
Pat, we hope that, don't we?
Yes.
Good. Frio would be probably the winners. Is that right, Frio?
Yes. Yeah, and well, it's your tip.
I've just scored this because I said I liked it. And Adidas came good last week.
They did.
Not a lot they sent in, but they sent in. No, they did. Thank you very much to Adidas. We didn't. We were only joking when we said we wanted stuff. Send more in. And so thank you to them. And thank you. That's a very good thing. I like that.
Yeah, I like that. Have fun with that. The next game, Bill?
Yes, indeed. It's Carlton taking on Sydney Sunday at Etihad. And Carlton were pretty good last week, Jimmy boy. Dale Thomas comes in. Good luck to Dale Thomas. Burn and Charlie Curnow, the boy from Geelong College. Good luck to him, brother Ov. He's in the squad there also. And they're pretty good, as I said. Casbolt just got to work on his kicking. Take on Sydney Swans. And weren't they outstanding last week? Belted the Bullies by 80 points. Buddy Franklin is back. Good to see Buddy back. Teddy Richards, Derek's, Jack and Rose come in. Talia is out with that foot injury. Oh, they were back. Going to... pretty good game this, because I didn't mind Carlton, but I'm going with Sydney to go 2-0. Sorry, and I've got a fat stat. Here's a good stat, fat stat, hashtag. The first six clubs alphabetically all lost in round one. Adelaide, Brisbane, Carlton, Collingwood, Essendon, Frio, all lost.
That might be the worst one you've come up with.
I'm now dumber, I think. Yeah, Carlton, I thought they were pretty good last week. Good to see Matty Wright, an ex-teammate of mine, kick three goals and go pretty well. But I think Sydney showed just what they're capable of doing last weekend, so I think they will win again.
Yeah, good to see Buddy back and kicking goals. Luke Parker was a star too. Sydney too strong.
Samuel?
Yes, take heart if you are a Carlton supporter, because they're going to be better. They might not win any games, but they're going to be better.
No, they'll win games.
They might win a few, not many. Essendon and Carlton would be a good game.
Mm-hmm.
So Sydney, I think.
Sydney, you think? Right. Time on the footy show for something that's grown in popularity enormously. Oh. It's what we call it. What the fuck? How this works is that the studio audience, and there are 300 or 400 of them, when they arrive, they're given a card and asked to fill in the question they've most wanted to ask Sam Newman. We pick out the three best, and then Sam never sees them and he's asked them live. Now, we're going to do it now because we think there's something even bigger coming up next. Oh. So, Byrne, have you got the first question?
I do.
Who on behalf of it are you asking?
I think it's from Ebony J.
Where are you, Ebony?
I'm not a good reader.
There she is, out in the middle there. Great to see you, Ebony. Righto.
Ebony. She wants to know, this interesting one, how old were you when you lost your virginity, Sam?
Oh!
Just careful with your answer. Yes. Please.
Stay up, Eb.
Well, yep. I gave it a savage. I remember giving it a savage workout in my early.
Too many details.
In my early teens, I was inexperienced, sure, but I remember I exploded in a crescendo of lather and sweat. Unfortunately, I was on my own at the time.
Right, on, Phil. Next one, thank you.
This one's from Nick Szabo. Nick,
where are you, Nick?
In the room.
There he is.
There you go. Nick was wondering if you could play a game for the Canterbury Cobras. We need some real presence down forward.
Oh.
I think he's half serious, too.
Can you saddle up for the Cobras?
Not even if I thought it'd solve world hunger.
We got a practice match this week. Can you play for us?
Practice match this week.
Is the mic on?
Yeah.
Not even if I thought it would solve world hunger would I come down there to where?
The Canterbury Cobras.
The Canterbury Cobras.
Oh, right. Geez, you'd get a crowd, Bill. Oh, imagine if he turned up to play
for the
Cobras.
Imagine the fox in his
white boots. All right, Bill.
Yes. All the best, mate. No, I can't play.
Brett from Bernie's Bucket List Band. Brett's over there, I'm assuming. Yep. He asks, are you and Bernie going to sing for us tonight?
I know. Come on, Bernie. Yeah.
Oh, welcome back to the Footy Show. We're nearly done for tonight. As we said, after the break, we're going to deliver you the boys. Dirty York, of course, the band who'll do a fantastic job. But before we get to that, I want to tell you what's on next week. Firstly, the beautiful debutante who will do a fantastic job. We can't wait for Beck Madden to be a part of the show. So next week, Trav Pike will be on. So will Joey Montagna, a very, very big edition of the Footy Show coming your way. But Bernie Vince, back in 2006, said that his lifetime ambition was to sing Sweet Home Alabama on the Footy Show. So now he can, with Sam Newman. Enjoy!